On this episode, I talk about the fidget spinner and why you need one. Hey there, Jed Corbinus here from JedCorbinus.com and welcome to Talk Therapy, the tool that I use to basically get to know my analytical mind, the mind, your ego, the voice that always is just sitting there telling you, let's do it tomorrow, let's do this, let's do that, let's not do that, let's distract you with every possible thing except the thing that you want to do, which makes you feel a little bit uncomfortable each day, but you're still pushing through it, still doing it, and that's what talk therapy is all about. Basically just throws it out there, gets past some of that, and gets me to the truth, right, to the truth of me. You can try it too, hit record, right? And then give it a shot, right? Just talk into your mic, just record yourself, whatever it is. You don't have to share it all over the place like I do. I just do it because maybe somebody might be inspired to change, to break the patterns of their current self, and then go from there. I don't usually premeditate anything. I don't usually think about this. I just hit record. But a little bit is going to be pre-thought about, not a lot, but I want to talk about something that I bought for a relatively low price, but it's not a sales pitch, right? It's a tool. And I first thought that this thing was like a complete joke. Like, who would buy one of these? Who would actually do this? Why would you need it? Why would you want it? And it's one of these things, right? It's called the fidget spinner, right? I actually like really thought it was stupid, vocalized every piece that I saw. Every single thing that I saw was like, stupid, why would you buy that? Blah, blah, blah. It's kind of the same thing as people talking about Snapchat. They're like, oh, Snapchat, it's never gonna get big, blah, blah, blah. Well, now Snapchat is massive, just saying. Like, there are so many users on Snapchat. Businesses are on Snapchat. I mean, same thing. The reason I bring up the fidget spinner is because at first it was like the cheapest one that I bought or saw. So I was like, fine, I'm gonna just see what the hype is. And then I started kind of playing with it, going, okay, well this is kind of pointless, but you know, not really, and it's kind of fun and. Can just sit there and mess with it or whatever. But then I applied it. I gave it an application. I gave it purpose. And now I'm like, okay, well, this is pretty sweet. Basically, it comes down to this. I used to smoke, right? I'm a former smoker. Smoked up to 2 packs a day before I quit. And now I chew a lot of sunflower seeds. And then on top of that, I chew my fingernails. Like, I won't even lie, I chew my nails. And I really wish I didn't do that. Like, I don't even wish, but I'm working on not. And I chew my fingernails in the car, which is even worse. Like, it's just a habit, a disgusting habit. So now this little thing, the fidget spinner, has now become like the chewing of the fingernails. Like, if I want to chew them, I grab the spinner and I just sit there and hold it in my hand and flick it, right? I can just flick it around. And all it is just to give the subconscious something to do. Like, chewing my fingernails was a habit because I would be excited. Like, the awareness that I have for the fingernails. So if you can't hear me very well, hopefully you can, but if you can't, it's raining cats and dogs out there, but yeah, so I just keep moving forward. But so I grab the fidget spinner, I chew my fingernails, or I don't chew my fingernails because of the fidget spinner, and I used to because I was excited, I'd be learning new things, I chew my fingernails, but now I just have this thing, like it's pretty crazy. I used to be running around, actually just driving around doing errands and chewing my fingernails, or driving home from work and chewing my fingernails. Not anymore, right? And I mean, you can do any, there's like fidget cubes, there's crazy amount of, like, this thing is probably gonna be a fad. Like, I don't know, maybe, but it might be a fad. But either way, I gave it a purpose. And, you know, if you have a child, if you have somebody who just doesn't maybe sit still, or, well, I mean, who knows? Like, a child may not like this. They might like it for, like, and a child, the only reason I say child is because I have a 2 and 5-year-old, right? Like, they may not like it for more than 30 seconds, and then they chuck it in the car, and then you're out, like, $4 or $5. But either way, give it some purpose, and then it's a little more meaningful. Like, I saw it. It was the cheapest I ever saw it, so I bought it and went, okay, well, this is dumb, right? And then I was like, oh, I bet you I can use this. Hopefully, maybe, somebody sees this and says, hey, I wonder if that'll work for me to quit smoking. Like, that would be cool. Anytime you want a cigarette, pull out the fidget spinner and just play with that for a little bit. And then go, oh, yeah, okay, I don't really need that cigarette. I'm glad I didn't have that cigarette. You know what I mean? Like, really give it a good spin, then you'd be okay. Like, really give it a solid spin, move it around, maybe bring it up to your face a little bit, act like you're smoking. Because that's really all the subconscious wants. It's just the oral fixation, right? Like, the movement. Who knows, right? It could work, it couldn't, doesn't matter.
Oh, I know. Oh, sure.
Late night studying, right? It comes down to this. It comes down to whatever you do, give it purpose. Like, you don't just buy stuff to buy stuff. Like, if you are addicted to stuff, like a lot of people are, then be very aware of why you're buying that stuff. Like, being stuff to make you happy, watch out, right? Like, nothing is ever gonna make you happy then. You're just gonna want more stuff. What about nothing? Like, right? Love nothing. And then anything past that is a win. So, like, I don't need anything to make me happy. When something does happen, it does make me happy, but I don't need it to happen. Anything past nothing is a win, right? Meaning one is greater than none. Like, so many people out there, they want like 17 of these things. They want 17 fidget spinners because they're just cool and they want to collect them. Well, do you actually need that many? Maybe you have them in 17 different spots. Now, I would see that. That's a valid point, where you want one in the car, you want one at home, you want one in the bathroom, you want one in the garage, you want one at work. Like, I get that. But if you need them to be happy, if you need stuff to be happy, watch out, you know. Just be very aware of your emotions. Like, if you're depressed, go online and you buy a bunch of shit, that's why you don't have any money. If you're depressed and you need a mental numbing moment, you just want to check out and you play, you know, the game on your phone and you, what is it, 99 cents or whatever for some of the games. Like, you should probably not buy that stuff. But I'm not saying don't. What I'm saying is, like, be aware of why you're purchasing something. Because that's what it's about. Awareness. How do you feel and why are you doing it? If it's not conducive to your life, then don't do it. Mentally check out in a different way. Go for a walk. Be active. Be active about your mental checkouts, right? Like, that's what I'm talking about. It's different ways to check out. It just takes practice, I think. It just takes a massive amount of practice. It takes some work. I say that a lot. Everything takes practice and work. That's what happens. get into the habit of working on you every day. Throw your fidget spinner around. Break those habits. It just takes practice. It's funny because I think we keep looking for stuff. Like, we keep looking for the next thing to, like, we keep looking for the next thing to solve our problems. And I think some of it will. I think some things will when you're ready to have them solve your problem. You just gotta be ready first. And how do you know you're ready? You just know. Like, okay, now I'm gonna do this because I'm ready. Now I'm gonna buy this because I'm ready. Like, I wanna open up this massive building, this massive gym, and this massive community center. But the question is, am I ready? I have to officially decide that I am ready in my own head first. I think I love the fantasy of talking about it. I think I love that more than actually opening up right now, like than actually opening it up. I think that's the cool part, like the underdog part. Like, if I open it up, that's the destination. That's like the end destination. Then what, right? Then I run it and operate it and I'm around it. And the only way it runs, if I'm there, I mean, that's cool, but I don't know, in my subconscious, I'm sitting here thinking, geez, that might be, you know, something that I don't want. I don't know. And that's my ego talking. That's the analytical mind saying, I don't know, is this really what we want? But I think I love the fantasy of talking about opening my own gym and dreaming about it and being the underdog, being the guy who opened up this massive community center for the two small towns that are 20 miles apart, and people come from all over to hop on this thing, to get in on it. I think that's a cooler fantasy to talk about than it is a reality for me right now, and that's okay. But the other thing is, people, they're starting to pay attention, for one. To share and do and actually pay and donate to the WADS. Like, pretty cool. I figure eventually a lot of people will be doing these things. A lot. Because it just takes maybe 20 minutes a day to do the WADS. People are doing it. And they're finding their results. They're finding their determination within themselves. And they're a part of a community that just cares. Consistency, determination, and community. That sums up the Cobra Nation right there. It's crazy cool how people make it all happen. Not stuff, but people. People make it all happen. At the end of the day, somebody made this fidget spinner. Somebody made this thing. And that is what matters most. People. The human being, the human experience. So different from person to person. You can be as positive as you want to be. But who are you really on the inside? Are you buying stuff left and right? Looking for an answer? Looking for something else? Or are you looking from within? And then deciding for yourself, okay, it's time. Today is the day. Go get it. Decide what you want. Maybe grab a fidget spinner and quit smoking. Right. That's it. That's all I got. A lot of fun. If you're willing to change from the neck up, you will change from the neck down. I believe in you. Now it's your turn to start believing in yourself. Stay safe out there. Be blessed. Bye for now.